Eagles, Bears. Coming up on EA Sports, we welcome you to Chicago, Illinois for today's game.
Phil, we've got a couple of the best tight ends in the game on each sideline today, and they could be the difference makers.
You know, these tight ends, they can do it all. They're tremendous blockers for the running game. They got the speed to go down the field, and they got feet, Jim. You know, those quick feet, so even when they run those short routes, if there's man-to-man coverage, they're quick enough and shifty enough to still get away from the defender.
This game is underway. And a flag is down. Two tight ends on the field here. First down at the 40.
Intercepted!
Well, it's a bad decision that time by the quarterback, and it results in an interception. When you throw one like that early in the game, it can definitely shake your confidence for the rest of the day.
What a place to start for the offense. The Eagles defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. Rodgers looking for a lane. Here's the starting offense with a receiving core that can be so dangerous in a game like this. Second down following the run.
You ready? Wide and yank! Wide and yank!
Hey. Langford's handed the football and picks up maybe three or four. If this defensive lineup is going to have the better of it today, it must get a big performance from Connor Barwin.
Connor Barwin, Jim, why they like him down here in Philadelphia is because he's big, rangy, and tough. That's what you want from your outside linebacker.
Timeout's called, and we're going to step aside and be back in just a moment. The line of scrimmage, the 35. The Eagles come out in a dime package. Cutler's got it in the gun. Looking to go deep, but it falls incomplete.
Well, my man at quarterback does have a strong arm. He showed it that time, didn't he? He threw that thing high and far and just overthrew the receiver.
Gold set now to attempt the field goal. With that one.
Long field goal try was missed there, Jim. I know it's early in the game, but that's just a bad job by the coach. Should have punted it and played field position.
Mark Sanchez has it under center. Will go ground. And Matthews is brought down. Taking a look at this offense now at tight end. 6'5" out of Stanford is Zach Ertz.
Yeah, he's a good presence inside, no doubt about it. When you talk about this Eagles offense, they got speed outside. They got the fast running back. They need their tight end to come through. Zach Ertz is that kind of guy.
Second down after going to the ground game the first play. Celek playing out of position in the backfield here. Handoff out of the eye. That's what happens when you try to guess the snap count.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The wide receiver in motion. Second down and two. And Matthews is going to get it from the eye. Looking at third down. Tosses the football. They bring him down, and the offense fails to pick up a first down on three plays. Donnie Jones now ready to punt. He's going to try and return this one. Has 12 on this play. First down at the 15. Langford's got it on the handball. Second down coming up. Langford's lined up in a single back formation. They better hurry to get the snap. Here's the handoff. Langford's brought down at the 21. It's third down coming up. The Eagles with two extra defensive backs in the dime. And it's batted down.
Well, Jim, that's a nice job by the defender knocking that football down on third down. That's what you want to do as a defense. Of course, you want to get off the field. Every time an offense completes a third down pass, their chances of getting a score on that drive go up big time. So getting off the field is great. Nice job by the defender.
Sproles is going to make the fair catch this time. The Eagles got absolutely nothing out of their previous possession, and here they are back on the field. Another three and out, I would have to think, would be very demoralizing to this team right now, Phil.
Yeah, it's going to be demoralizing to the offense, but I'll tell you who's going to be more demoralized is the defense, because they need to sit on the sidelines and get a little rest. So I know there's a lot of pressure on this offense right now.
Corners are backing off here. The Eagles snap it at the 41. Cooper has the reception.
Well, when you know you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well go ahead and try to make the throw, because you're going to take the hit no matter what. Good job by the quarterback that time.
They come to the line, and it's first down. It's Sproles in the backfield. Sproles gets the football. Game's about three. One player to keep an eye on today is Pernell McPhee.
Yeah, what I like about him is Jimmy can play about four different positions on the field. Outside, inside, he can do whatever you want on the defensive side.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. Sproles. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
Set up now at the 32. Selleck's a tight end, but now shifted into the backfield. First down and 10. Matthews is tackled down at the 31.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
They come to the line at the 31-yard line. Defense respecting the deep ball, playing way off the receivers. Second and 9. And now here's Sproles on the toss.
Sproles trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
This is third down. Playing press coverage to the outside. Throws the pass. Almost intercepted that time.
Good play that time by the defender. He read the quarterback, got in position, and knocked that pass away on third down.
This will be a field goal attempt from 45 yards out. No doubt about it. Put three on the board. Nearing the end of the first quarter, and the 3 points on the board puts them ahead.
Got to feel good about that drive. That was nice. Of course, it didn't lead to a touchdown, but it was good enough to get you 3 points.
He's got a chance to return this one. Breaks free. And he's on the sidelines and out of bounds. The Bears offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive. A quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players, and they're pretty excited. So this is going to be tough on the offense. Well, the offense has done a good job getting down inside the 20 in the so-called red zone or green zone by some teams. But the defense can be a little more aggressive now.
because you don't have to worry about the length of the field. It is shortened, so take advantage of it and attack this offense a little more.
Only 20 yards to the end zone. We're now about to begin quarter number two. And how much pressure do you think these offenses are feeling right now to open this game up, partner?
Jim, I'm going to go back to when I played. The longer you go in a game without having success, I think it makes you tighter and you lose confidence on the offensive side. So they need something here to get them off to a quick start and get them feeling good.
At the 20-yard line, and now in the red zone.
Hello, baby, alert, alert, ready, wide and yank, wide and yank.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Secures it with two hands.
Well, they complete the pass, Jim, but doesn't get the first down. Sooner or later, you got to throw one down the field.
Third down. The Eagle sat at the line. Dime package. Cutler is going to take it from the gun. Looking across the middle. Touchdown, Chicago Bears. And here in quarter number two, they've taken the lead with that touchdown.
Yeah, the offensive coordinator, boy, he's got to be happy with the play calls and the execution by the players on the offensive side. That was a good, smart drive.
Are prepared to return the kickoff. Sproles is going to test the coverage this time. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Eagles bring their offense onto the field. The last time they had control of the football, they did not come away empty-handed, but did not get a touchdown either.
Well, they got that field goal, and I think that's important. That field goal gave them a little confidence. They got some points up there that always makes you feel good on the offensive side. Now take advantage of that good feeling. Go out there and score a touchdown this time.
Let's see if they can finish off a drive. Mark Sanchez has it under center. First down at the 21. They'll run it here.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
The Bears' defense now is going to go nickel. Second and 11. They go screen with Sproles.
Well, but it's third and long. I'll just say this. Be very careful on the offensive side.
Third down now. The corner step back. Mark Sanchez from the gun. And it's in the hands of Zach Ertz.
Good job by the defense. Staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle. And now we have fourth down coming up.
So now they'll call on Jones to punt the football. And the punt is kicked out of bounds. The Bears offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
Picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
Down the field.
Got the catch. One-handed.
What must it be like to be able to go down there and make a play like that? How about one-handed catch? That was special.
Scrimmage, the 36. Jay Cutler takes a look now from under center. Royal on the reception. Royals tackled down at the 17.
That's a good job by the quarterback recognizing it's man-to-man defense. And when you see that, just watch the receiver leading to the open space. Nice completion.
Cutler's now completed 4 in a row. The line of scrimmage is the 17.
All right, here we go. Wide and yank. Wide and yank. Hello, baby. Alert. Alert.
Trying to beat the play clock. Langford's going to secure the handoff. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
You got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short gain.
The 13.
Here we go. Zebra.
Second down and 6. Langford's taking the handoff. That picks up 7.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now it becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
At the 6. Press coverage all the way. First and goal from the 6. Staying with the ground. Runs it in for the touchdown. They continue to add to their lead, Phil, late in the second quarter. And so far, there's been no looking back.
Yeah, it's all working on the offensive side. And listen, don't take this for granted. Stay aggressive. Keep putting keep throwing that gas on the fire, pedal to the metal. Whatever cliche you want to use, use it and keep the pressure on.
Robbie Gould ready to kick it. Sproles is going to run this one out. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Eagles offense failed to muster a single first down the last time they had it. Let's see if their offense this time can create a few sparks.
Well, you know the coaches were upset at them when they went to the sideline. So the sense of urgency is there. You should be fired up, and I expect a better drive this time.
First down at the 19. And Sproles is brought down. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Sproles is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
second down here after that run play. The corners retreating. Here's Ertz. That's another reception. Give him two.
This tight end's very talented. He's a good run blocker and also a good receiver. Makes a nice catch on that throw.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Outside now on the toss. Sproles is taken down at the 46.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
It's now second down and five after running it on first down. Matthews in the backfield. Single back set. And the give to Ryan Matthews. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
You're running back in this league and you pick up first downs and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
Bump coverage here. Corners backing up. Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. Ball almost comes away with a pick that time.
Incompletion by the quarterback that time. It was good, tight, man-to-man coverage.
Leads us to second down. We're moving in on the 2-minute warning. One more snap first. And Sproles is brought down. That's going to be a pickup of 10. We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. That last play was a run. Third down coming up. Eagles will take the snap from the 35. Sproles is brought down after picking up just a yard.
Sproles able to get it done that time. Why? Because he has the power and the will to make it happen. Third short, he just gets it done with sheer willpower.
It's first down as they head to the line.
The D-line all talking. I think they're expecting run. That's why they're shifting to their left.
They go screen with Sproles. They have this one covered up, and it's going to set them back for a loss.
Scrimmage is the 38-yard line.
From the shotgun, he'll throw it over the middle. Two hands on the football and has the catch. And the offense will need 3 yards here on third down after the completion.
Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the play off. Don't use the timeout here. Good clock management.
Intercepted.
Isn't it awesome on the defensive side where you have linebackers can make plays like that? getting that interception. It's not always defensive backs that get to make those plays. Linebackers can do it too.
Bears take it from the 28. Got hit on release.
When you see this cover two defense as a quarterback, you got to know where to throw the football. That time he did not make a good decision. You got to throw it sometimes deep down the middle. The safeties are not there. They're outside. He did not take advantage of that coverage that time.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. The Eagles will come out in the dime. Airing it out. Very nearly intercepted.
Well, when you get in a situation like this, Jim, and you get third and long, I'll tell you what catches a defense by surprise. Run a double move on the outside against the defensive back. Because everybody in the stands and the defensive players all think you're going to throw it short.
The offense now needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Walks to go deep. The play. The Bears, one timeout remaining. Set up now at the 36. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. And it's knocked down.
Nice job that time by the defensive player. He is all over the receiver in this man-to-man coverage, and there was just nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football.
Second down after the incompletion. It's caught by Kevin White. The Bears with no timeouts left.
Jim Nance, that was the old fly route. When we were kids, that's what they called him. See if you can fly by the defensive back. He did that time. Nice throw catch.
The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20. This will most likely be the final play before the half ends. Pass hits the ground and goes incomplete on the short throw.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
A short field goal try on the way. Drives it through for the field goal. The team's heading to our pal Larry Ridley as you watch the NFL on EA Sports. The Bears are ready to return the kick. The second half is officially underway.
They're setting up the return.
Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Bears take the field here in the second half, looking to extend their lead in this one, partner.
Yeah, you know what you do? It's halftime is over. You come out here, you're not sure what the new game plan is going to be, but feel your way into the game. Don't take a chance early and turn the football over.
The Eagles go with the dime formation here on defense. And now here's the first snap of the second half. Langford's taken down at the 25.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Coming up, second down. They need to get the playoff. Almost intercepted.
Now the quarterback can't get him open. He threw to the right guy that time, but the coverage was so good by the defense, nowhere to get the completion.
Third and six coming up. Double tight end formation. The Bears will take the snap from the 25. And he's going to be sacked. So just three plays and out for the offense. They're set to punt it away now. Sproles from the 25. And the tackle is made at the 41.
The Eagles love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
Sproles lines up as the single back here. The Eagles snap it at the 41. Intercepted. Tackles made.
Sometimes as a quarterback, you just misjudge the talent on the other side. And what a play by the linebacker picking off the pass. What a pair of hands also.
The Bears weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt as they take the field here. Do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
No, it's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
Bennett had it but couldn't hold it as this goes incomplete.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
Ready, go ready.
Oh, you see the linebackers moving around. I think they're trying to confuse the offensive line.
The Bears have it at the 29. It's wide open. Chicago, touchdown. Langford, second touchdown of the game.
If you talk about fast running backs, you don't have to give them a lot. Block them a little bit with his speed. He sees it opening, and he can make it happen. Takes it all the way for the touchdown run.
The Bears for the extra point kick. Driving extra point is good. The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. Sproles is running this one out. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Eagles offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
The Eagles have it at the 24. Matthews with the reception. Corners are backing off here. First down at the 46. Sproles looking out wide. After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8.
Zebra!
They bring in the extra tight end.
Zebra!
Look at the signals. The D-line is all shifting down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
They advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Inside the 50. Third down and 3. Ryan Matthews takes the handoff. The Eagles will go for it here on fourth down and short. Way through the third quarter. Matthews has it out of the eye.
I thought that was a pretty risky play that time by the offense. Even though it's the second half and you're down, you don't always have to go for it on fourth down. Fortunately for them, they got it that time.
Here they come to the 41-yard line.
Well, that's a good job of the linebackers moving around. They're trying to confuse the offensive line.
And they can't connect.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. Celek's usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time. Throws the pass. Underneath, but can't find a mark that time as the pass goes incomplete. after the incomplete pass, it's third down. Mark Sanchez from the gun. Heaving it down the field. This will be ruled incomplete. Didn't get the feet down.
The Eagles don't have a lot of options on third and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
Donnie Jones now ready to punt. Looking to make a difference. That's a gain of six.
The Bears could have asked for this third quarter to have gone any better for them than it has so far, as they've just continued to do what they were doing in the first half, up and down the field.
Oh, man, they kept the pedal to the metal, man. They are letting it go. They're being aggressive, and they're trying to end this game right here.
The Eagles lined up in the nickel. Jay Cutler from the shotgun. Launches it down the field. Incomplete.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Second down and 10. Jay Cutler with the deep ball. Great grab there. Snags it with one hand.
White, such a great athlete. And of course, you got to be a great athlete to be able to make a catch like that.
Ball spotted at the 49-yard line. That long gain sets them up here on this play. Cutler is back in shotgun formation. And it's swatted away. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here.
Quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Royals there to catch him on his way. Taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
We're late third, Phil, and kind of like looking at you, this game is getting uglier by the minute.
Wow, you know, and everybody says you're a nice guy. Now, see, you say things like that, and you just ruin your reputation, a man of the people. Heck, oh well. Well, you know, Jim, sometimes you got to say mean things. This game has been mean too. One team is getting blown out.
Robbie Gould ready to kick it. No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. The Eagles didn't get much out of that last drive, so now here they come again on offense. I'm sure they're going to be a little bit more of an urgency to the offense this time.
Well, I'll just say this to you, Jim Nance. I sure hope so. After that last drive, that was just too generic, wasn't very well thought out, and they got to change what they're doing on the offensive side.
Got to give that defense a little credit, though, don't you?
Well, yeah, the defense did its job, but man, that was pretty easy.
Forgive. Sproles is tackled down at the 32.
All you can do is your job, and that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
It's a two tight end formation. The Eagles from the 32. And in incomplete. What a hit that time.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
This will be second down. Sproles lines up as the single back here. Darren Sproles makes the catch. Gains 16.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
Sproles is in the backfield. They're going back up top. Looking across the middle. Second down following that incompletion. Defense respecting the deep ball, playing way off the receivers. He'll throw it over the middle. Should have had it.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Third down on the way. The Bears defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. Throws the pass. That's an interception. That brings the play to an end. They throw a pick here, Phil, and they'll be very pleased that we're nearing the final quarter so they can get this one over.
You know, sometimes when you're losing like this and you're playing so bad, you just feel like you can't get the game over with. It's amazing how it just keeps dragging on. And, man, this has been a bad day. And it's, like you said, Jim, it just continues.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
It's intercepted. Late in the third, and will this be the spark that somehow inspires the offense to get back into the game?
It could, Jim. I'll say this. For the offense, have a sense of urgency. This is it. You need to score after that turnover to get back in this game.
The corner step back. The Eagles have it at the 34. Takes it out of the eye.
The Bears defensive coordinator, my gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield and stop a runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
Loss of four on the play. Sproles is lined up directly behind the quarterback here. Darren Sproles with the catch.
That was a nice job by the offense. It just puts them in a better position. Nice little throw and catch.
So they get the reception, but it's not enough to move the chains. Third down coming up. Murray lined up in the backfield. Going to be dumped. And that's a three and out.
We got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down. And they get back to the quarterback and take it down.
The fourth quarter about to begin, and this game is well in hand.
It sure is. It's been just a total dominant performance, a blowout, whatever you want to say. And I give the team a lot of credit. They played well. They had a tremendous game plan on the other side. It's only one game. Go back, start all over again, and this time next week, you could be the team that's on top.
Wants to give it a go here. And he's going to be tackled right around the 43. And a run back of about five. The Bears' last possession ended somewhat painfully with an interception.
You wonder if they're going to try to compensate for that mistake on this drive, Phil.
Well, sometimes when you have a mistake on the offensive side, it does make you get more conservative. But let's look at it from the defensive side. It was just a tremendous play. So sometimes in the NFL, that's going to happen where the defensive player is just better than the offensive player.
I know you had a lot of experience at this, but after you threw an interception, what was it like coming back out?
Another takeaway. He's brought to a halt. This one is well out of reach, and that's more of a moral victory for this defense than anything else.
Well, it's a good moral victory. Anytime you get an interception, make the other team make a mistake, that is good for your defense. And, you know, I don't know. I don't think this game is over. I'm saying to the offense, let's see if you can go out there and score quick, and let's make a game of this.
Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. The defense gets a sack.
Oh, man, defensive coordinators love this. When you can hit, or this time, they sack the quarterback without even blitzing.
It's now second down. Mark Sanchez from the gun. Almost intercepted.
It's not always about being safe on third long. Every coordinator has a group of plays that they like on third and 15 plus. So it could be seams, double moves, plays where you catch the defense by surprise and you can pick up a very tough first down situation.
The Eagles take it from the 43. Ball's picked off. This offense had no choice but to take some chances here in the fourth quarter, but it comes back to bite them again with an interception.
Well, but it's not going well, and you start trying to take chances, there is nothing going to go right in that situation. If they get back on the field after this one, Jim, just go out there, run the football, and try to get this game over with.
First down at the 48. Trying to find an opening to the right, and that gains one.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run, nowhere for the running back to go, and they stopped him for a short gain.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Langford's in the backfield, single back set. Looking across the middle, and Royal is brought down.
Tick, 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 tick. That's what we're trying to do. Make that clock keep running down. You got the offense out there. You got a big lead in the second half. Every first down you get shortens that football game.
Rodgers lined up in the backfield. Wide and yank. Wide and yank. And now on first down, they'll go back to the air. Jaquizz Rodgers with the reception.
I think the coach on the sidelines, he's going to be happy with every first down because he knows that's more time off the clock. When you're up like this, multiple scores in the second half, every first down just puts the odds in your favor of winning this game.
Cutler's completion percentage, 50% on the day.
Red 18! Red 18!
First down at the 16. Jaquizz Rodgers with the reception. Graham's there that time for the tackle.
Well, the only thing I can say about that play, it was better than an incompletion. The quarterback gets the completion, and they pick up a yard or two.
The pass play picks up only 2, so now it's second down and 8 following the completion. Cutler steps back into the gun. And it's batted down.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
Breaking huddle at the 14-yard line.
Here we go.
Third and 8. Hit as he throws it. J. chip shot here. The kick is good.
Midway through the fourth quarter, this game was already out of reach, but they went ahead and added a field goal to add a little insult to injury.
Well, you listen, this is pro football, man. You know, you got to stop the other team. They didn't do it, so sometimes you deserve to be blown out.
The Bears ready here for the kickoff. Sproles is going to test the coverage here. Ball is going to make the tackle. And a run back of about 17. The Eagles are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You've got to go out there and be much better.
Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. An open lane. The Eagles now move the chains.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better. Finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
All right, here we go.
The Eagles snap it at the 31. And it's knocked down.
That was excellent man-to-man coverage at time. When you want to shut down a receiver, really the only way to do it is to man up and play him one-on-one.
The corners retreating. Second and 10. Sproles takes it out of the eye. Following the run, it's now third and 7. Selleck, a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play. Murray with the reception. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. It has been a dominating performance in all facets, Phil, but I think it starts with the defense, which is still starring in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they've been tremendous all day long. I'm gonna tell you what, they're gonna feel good about themselves when this game is over tonight. And I'll tell you, I think they'll carry this momentum into next week's practice. They're gonna be tough again next week.
They're going to go for it here on 4th and 6. It's Sproles in the backfield. That's going to be a timeout charge to the offense. The offense is still on the field here on 4th down, needing 6 for the first. The Eagles will take the snap from the 35. Out to Cooper. Porter's there to take him down.
All you can do is your job, and that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
First down here after the completion. Mark Sanchez from the gun. down the field. Pass is intercepted.
He's into the open. He's in the clear.
The 10.
This is going to be an interesting week of practice for this offense as they'll try to put this performance behind them. But here's one last interception for them to try to get over.
Well, if I was the head coach of this football team, I'd give him a little pep talk when the game is over, that he knows better times are ahead, and I would not even watch the film of this game tomorrow.
The Bears will have to punt. And a touchback.
The Eagles offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
No bump coverage here. Corners backing up. Gets it out for the completion.
That's a nice route on the outside. Nice throw by the quarterback. Puts him in good position to keep moving and get a first down.
And now we reach the two-minute warning. Drop back, shotgun formation. And look out, it's Sproles with the catch. Sproles is tackled down at the 32.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
The Eagles from the 32. Darren Sproles makes the catch. So they complete that one, yet it's still second down.
Here we go. Red 18. Red 18.
Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. Launching it deep, but they can't connect.
Matthews, one of those guys, if he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver, the
Bears come out in a dime package. Darren Sproles takes the football. He's tackled right at the 48.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better, finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later. Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad after getting sacked like that by the defensive end. Your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
Mark Sanchez from the gun. Looking long. Hooper's got it on a pass that had something taken off of it.
All you can do is your job. And that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. Breaks free, has some space to work with. Going to take it the distance. The 30, the 20, the 10. Ducks out of bounds.
Well, Phil, I enjoyed watching the game with you, and how about a final thought about that victory?
Well, you know, Jim, I wish I could say the same, that I enjoyed spending these last 3 hours with you, but that's just not the case. But, no, just kidding, of course. Nice win. They got to feel good about what they've done and celebrate a little tonight.
I think I'll see you next week, maybe. So for Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.